What is the effect of anti-seizure medications on the bones? So here's the thing, taking anti-seizure medications for a while, especially for the seizure medications that are older ones like phenobarbital, phenytoin, dilantin, carbamazepine, tegretol, all of those anti-seizure medications and even valproic acid, Depakote, they have some effects on the liver, and on the long term, they can cause issues with the bones. So what happens is that it can cause osteoporosis and bone thinning, and that can lead to fractures. And you know, epilepsy people are prone to falls, and that can be detrimental, like, you know, having falls and having seizures that can break bones and on the long term. So what we need to do is this. So if you are on any anti-seizure medication that I mentioned, you should always check the bone levels and do a DEXA scan, which can measure the bone density. Also, what we can do is to take vitamin D and calcium all the time, like every single day, take vitamin D and calcium. And if you do have osteoporosis, there are two things we can do. First of all, if those medications can be changed to a newer medication that does not have issues on the liver, we can do that. We can switch the medicine. And the second thing, we should take osteoporosis treatment like bisphosphonate and other medications for osteoporosis specifically under the endocrinologist or the bone doctor guidance. And there are many medications for seizures, and to learn which is the best medication for seizures to replace, you can see this video and stay healthy, and see you in the next one.